happening? This is Andy coming to you again from my Daily Funk Club headquarters here in Colorado. And it's time for me to do another demo with the awesome 20th anniversary Reverend Guitars Mercalli 5-string. I met those guys down at the Dallas International Guitar Festival, and we hit it off and became friends very quickly. I was drawn to this instrument visually at first, and then when I picked it up and played it, I was really blown away. I had known about Reverend from previous years when they had the Rumblefish bass, and I always thought that was cool because, you know, they have this really interesting and unique kind of retro hip, you know, kind of atomic age kind of, you know, shape and look to them and everything. It's definitely original, and it's definitely retro, and they're doing stuff that nobody else is really doing, so I like that. After playing the instrument, I was really impressed by it, especially considering the price point. You know, this bass, this is like a special edition, you know, 20-year anniversary instrument, and it's still, I think it's still well under $1,500. A couple of the things that I found that I've come to find to be very, very impressive about it, particularly has to do with the quality of the instrument. In terms of the way that it's holding up, because I've had this bass here now for over 4 months. It was shipped to me with the most amazing fret dressing and setup. You know, really, really, really nice, like way above average compared to some of the other stuff that I've received. And now here it is 4 months later. I've never taken an Allen wrench to this thing. I've never adjusted it. I've never done anything to it. And it's still absolutely perfect. The edges of the frets are nice and round and soft. There's been no fretboard drying or shrinking, and that's just a testament of the quality of the wood that they're using and the way that the instrument is set up and prepped before being sent out. So in this price place, I really don't think you could find a better value. You just can't, not in this, you know, $1,300 or whatever it is, $1,350. I don't know exactly. In terms of construction, it has a laminated neck, you know, five-piece laminated neck and a Carina wood body. It's got this beautiful maple, flame maple top with the kind of sky blue transparent finish on there. Nice brushed aluminum pickguard on there. Really, really, really nice heavy-duty bridge that strings through the back of the instrument, which really, really, really beefs up the overall, you know, vibration of everything. It's got these locking saddles. Once you set it all up, you lock it in, and it's got the nice thick walls on the sides of the bridge that you know, hold everything in place. So this bridge ain't going anywhere. It's an incredibly well thought out and stout bridge design. Genuine hip shot tuners on there, you know, premium tuners. And it's got completely passive electronics. They got their own pickups in there. This is the split brick and this is the thick brick. This is kind of like a, if you notice the way the poles are shaped, it's like a reverse P in the front and then a big, like, you know, dual coil kind of humbucker Music Man style pickup in the back. Completely passive bass. It has a few simple controls, volume, tone, and blend. It comes with a black blend control knob. I put a chrome one on there because I like the tele knob on there, but it comes with a black one. It's the only thing I changed on this bass is one knob. Let's see. Let's hear what it sounds like. Okay, so right now, let's go. We'll start in the P bass, the front split brick pickup. Thank you. that's just the P-bass, just the split brick in the front. That's an amazing passive tone. And something that I should mention here is how great the B string sounds. Typically, passive five strings don't have the kind of muscle in the low B. Sometimes they just don't. They just don't fly when they're passive five strings. But this one, super killer, tight, very rich tone. You know, there's no buzz or flap. The tension is great. Fantastic B string. Okay, so let's go to, now we'll go to both pickups. Pickup starts to have a little bit more of like a hi-fi sound, if you want to call it that, you know, that kind of slightly scooped out. You lose a little bit of mid-range, but you gain a little bit of like high-end clarity, you know. Kind of like a pretty great passive slap sound. And now we'll go to just the back pickup. Mid-range kind of barky, bitey sound is fantastic. You know, if you're into ghost note playing and that kind of a thing, playing on the back pickup naturally takes you there. It really makes all the rhythmic, percussive, ghost notey kind of things jump out. Harmonics, very rich. Very alive. You know, the instrument is very alive, very sassy, and very awake. You know what I mean? It's not one of these ones, it's not one of these basses that you really have to struggle with to get it to sing or to get it to get the harmonics to jump out. know, it's rich with overtone content. And all that stuff just wants to jump out effortlessly. So this is a bass that performs at least twice its value, you know what I'm saying? It's a $3,000 bass that you can get for half that. In terms of the way that it performs and the quality of it, the way that it holds up. Job of the with their setups. They get the instruments and then they set them up really, really nice there in Ohio at their headquarters, and then they ship them out. And you know, in terms of my personal preference, I never like a bass that has a blend control right in the middle. It's just a little bit too out of focus for me, for my taste, but it's not a bad thing, that's just the way it is. That's just natural. What I do like is rolling it slightly to the front or slightly to the back, just past the middle. So I use that center indent only as a point of reference because I'm never on the center indent. I'm always slightly rolled forward or slightly rolled backwards. And this is what you get when you roll it slightly forward. Slightly to the back pickup. So what a cool instrument that you can get for, you know, a great value. Plus, it's kind of a historical collector's thing, you know. This bass is, they're only making it this year because it's their 20th anniversary. So I would strongly encourage you to get one of these. Have, hold, and love it for a long, long time. It's a very, very well-made and affordable instrument that has a unique cool factor to it that will definitely, you know, make you stand out in the crowd in terms of the instrument that you're playing on stage. All right, friends, have a great day. Rock on.